Who taught you to hate yourself from the top of your head to the soles of your feet?
You want to look like what you are? What makes you ashamed of being black?
Which doll is the black doll? And which one is the white doll?
That one.
Which doll is the pretty doll? Which doll is the nice doll? Which doll is the bad doll? Which doll is the nice doll? And which doll is the bad doll? And why is that doll pretty?
Because she's white and he has two eyes.
Which doll is the ugly doll? Why is that doll ugly?
Because he's black.
Who taught you to hate the shape of your nose and the shape of your lips? Who taught you to hate the color of your skin to such extent that you bleach to get like the white man?
My father started rehearsals every day after school.
My brother, Michael Jackson.
If you could tell me a little bit about growing up and wanting to play baseball and playing baseball.
There's a new twist this morning in the Sammy Sosa skin cream saga. Sosa admits he has been using a skin cream to treat his aging skin. The cream bleached his face and changed his appearance.
Who taught you to hate your own kind?
Hate you black bastards. You stink. Hate your black skin. Hate my gums because they black. I hate Whoopi Goldberg's lips. Hate the back of Forrest Whitaker's neck. Most of all, I hate that black-ass Wesley Snipes.
Who taught you to hate the race that you belong to? So much so that you don't want to be around each other.
I like light skin better because I feel it's more beautiful. I don't like dark skin because it looks dirty to me. I don't like dark skin because it looks dirty to me. I do not like the big nose. I do not like the big lips. When I look at a black person with a big nose, they look like monkeys. Basically, society categorized me as black, but I don't see myself as black. I'm not black. I don't want to be black. Being black has been a curse. Being born black has been a curse.
I know right now through what you're saying that you are not well in your head.
Tell you right now, your opinion doesn't matter because you're black. What you should have did was bleach your skin, and you should have lost some weight and changed your nappy hair.
Not like black people.
I wouldn't say I don't like black people. I don't like black women because they're really evil, hateful, and envious.
Sounds like you don't like black women.
No, I don't.
Well, you don't like yourself.
No, I'm not black.
What are you?
I'm mixed. I'm not black.
You are black. You just don't want to admit it. You just hate yourself.
Who taught you to hate yourself?
Truth will free you from anything, and Negroes don't know the truth. You find a Negro getting drunk, he doesn't know the truth. You find a Negro taking dope, he doesn't know the truth. You find a Negro lying and cheating, he doesn't know the truth. He's usually imitating the white man. Negroes get drunk because they see white people get drunk. They smoke cigarettes because they see white people smoke cigarettes. They commit fornication and adultery because when they turn on the television, all they see is a white man committing fornication and adultery. So, and they want to be like the white man, so they copy his immoral social habits.
The white man has brainwashed the so-called Negro to the point of believing in white supremacy so much that today some Negroes think that they're not making progress or they don't have anything unless they're living in a white neighborhood, unless they have the white man's neighborhood, a seat in the white man's school, or a position on the white man's job, and they even have taken it so far they don't think they're successful in life unless they have a white woman as a wife.
Fred, you say that all black women are evil.
Yeah, that's right.
Fred, why only white women? What is it about them?
Because, like I said, if it ain't white, it ain't right.
Why do black men, then, Brian, go out with white women?
And I go out with white girls because
I find him, in some cases, a better person.
Oh my God! The mother of Mecca is right here before me! Do my eyes not deceive me, or am I looking at the goddess Isis herself? Can you do me a favor, my brown skin angel? Can you tap that white girl for me? My milk of magnesia. Oh! Oh, after the devil made you, he broke the mold. Well, maybe you and I could make a little jungle fever.
70% of African American women are single. Mm-hmm. Rona is 28 and single. What's your take on that statistic?
That actually does not surprise me at all. Something that I've noticed in the past 10 years especially is that a lot of black women are opting to date non-black men. Well, I, you know, came up in a predominantly white area. Really, sometimes, well, in a lot of cases, I find that I have more in common with non-black men, mm-hmm. in some cases, than black men.
And I always ask my mother, I said, Mother, how come is everything white? And the angel food cake was the white cake, and the devil food cake was the chocolate cake. And everything bad was black. The little ugly duckling was the black duck. And the black cat was the bad luck. And if I threaten you, I'm gonna blackmail you. I said, Mama, why don't they call it white male? They lied too. This is when I knew something was wrong.
Everything the white man taught you, you accepted. He taught you you were a black heathen, and you believed him. He taught you that black was a curse, and you believed that. Did you ever look up the word black in a dictionary? Black, destitute of light, devoid of color. Enveloped in darkness, hence utterly dismal or gloomy, as the future looked black.
Pretty good with them words, ain't you?
Soiled with dirt, foul, sullen, hostile, forbidding, as a black day. Foully or outrageously wicked, as black cruelty. Indicating disgrace, dishonor, or culpability. And there's others. Black male, black ball, black guard.
Yeah, well, that's something all right.
Let's look up white. Here. Read.
White. Of the color of pure snow. Reflecting all the rays of the spectrum. The opposite of black. Free from spot or blemish. Innocent. Pure. Huh. Ain't this something? Without evil intent. Harmless. Honest. Square dealing and honorable. Wait a minute. But this was written by white folks though, right? I mean, this white folks book?
This sure ain't no black man's book.
So what we reading this one for?
Because the truth is lying there. If you read behind the words. You got to take everything the white man says and use it against him.
Your times will never get better until you make them better.
Stop name calling each other. Stop gossiping about one another. Stop squabbling with one another. Stop snitching on one another. Snitching means informing to racists for reasons of personal gain. Stop being discourteous to one another. Stop being disrespectful to one another. Stop stealing from one another. Stop robbing one another. Stop fighting one another. Stop killing one another. And I add, stop using and selling drugs to one another. And last but not least, stop throwing trash.
That when Negroes stop getting drunk, when Negroes stop fornicating and committing adultery, when Negroes stop being addicted to drugs and these things that destroy the moral fiber, and the morale of the Negro, then our people will be able to get together and unite in harmony and unity and get our own problem solved.